Doing amazing. I wanted to take a break from all of my packing and getting slides together and all of that to jump into the group for a minute and talk to you about something that is a really hot topic for a lot of my clients and a lot of people I've been having conversations with. And that is this idea of leveling up in your business, of stepping into that next what's possible space. And I see so many people struggle to figure out what is that next level. How do you get clear enough on what you're doing? How do you get the right strategy in place? And that is really what it comes down to, is getting really clear on a couple of key things that I don't see a lot of people talking about, and then really focusing on strategic implementation. There is so much out there, especially right now around us, about just hustle, 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 work harder, put in more effort, more energy, more everything, and put in your time and things will start to work, right? We hear that with all of these different campaigns. Build out a webinar campaign, build out a book funnel, build out a whatever it is. And it's 3 months, 6 months, a year from now, things might magically start working. And the good news is it's actually a lot easier than that. The bad news is you have to get really strategic in a way that most people aren't talking about right now. What do I mean by that? What I want to share with you in this live stream is the five key pieces that make all the difference between what level you are at as an entrepreneur, as a business owner, and really as a leader in your space. So let's talk about that for a minute. And what I'm going to do in this live stream also is invite you guys to join me Sunday. I am hosting a private mastermind in New York. It's a small group. We will be in a private room going through this stuff and actually figuring these pieces out. So if you hear me talking about this and you think, yeah, these are some pieces I want to get clear on. I want to be more strategic and more focused with my time so that I'm getting the maximum results possible in the minimum amount of time in my business. I'll put a link near the video where you can join us for the live stream, get some cool bonuses and stuff. But I want to go through these five steps with you. Let me scroll down on my screen. Actually, I'm going to share screen so I can show you guys what I'm looking at. Let's see here. All right. I think I've got, I'm trying to get me and a small. There we go. Now you can see my screen a little bigger. So when you're looking at this concept of leveling up in your business, and you know what that means for you, you already know what are the goals you're working on, what are the things that you really want to get out there and do, what are the stages maybe that you want to get on? What are the programs that you might want to launch that you've been holding back on, that you don't feel like you're quite ready for? Normally, when that's going on, it's actually nothing to do with your expertise. Your holding back, your waiting is more to do with not feeling clear and not feeling like you've got the right strategy, right? You're an expert at what you do already, and you know when the right person comes to you, you can get them amazing results. But how do you take that and package it and get it out there in a way that other people immediately see the value and get excited about? To do that, you have to be really clear on a couple of things, and you've got to have the right strategy. So let's talk about this. So a couple of key pieces that a lot of people are missing, and we're going to go into how you come up with these in just a second, but I want to zoom in here and show you these. You have to have a way of expressing what you do and what you stand for, what you care about, why you do what you do, and what I call a manifesto, right? You've seen these before. How many of you actually have one for your business? Do you actually have, and it might be called a manifesto, it might be called a code, it might be called your statement of values, it may be the rules, right? Depending on what you call it, the document can have lots of different names, but you have to have a code. You have to have a, these are our 10 commandments type document, type message, that when somebody reads it, they go, oh, yes, that's what I believe too. That's for me, right? Planet Business has one. I'll share it in the comments so that you guys can get an idea of how this works, but it's a way to express what is it that you stand for, both you as a person and your company? What do you stand for? What's the movement that you want to create, the change you want to see? And how do you express that in a way that gets your clients excited? That's one of the key pieces to really getting clarity in your business. If you know what your revolution is, what your movement is, then you can go out with your message in a way that people get excited about. So you get a totally different reaction when you're talking to people. The second thing is having a really clear core offering. Now, you've probably got a signature system, or if you don't, you're aware that you need one, right? You want a signature system, but there's more to it than just knowing what it is you offer, right? Your offer is not, I have 5 video modules for you that are going to walk you step by step through how to set up your profile on Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, and Instagram. And you're going to be able to get traffic from it and find clients. That's not your offer. Your offer has to be focused on the result you deliver, right? Your offer is actually, hey, would you love to know how to use social media to get clients coming to you in a way that saves you time and gets you more of your perfect clients while feeling like you're able to show up fully expressed as you? People actually understand you and the value of what you do. Which one of those do you rather want? You don't really want more video trainings and modules. What you really want is the end result of being able to show up as who you are, tell people what it is you can do for them, and have them hand you a credit card and say, I want to get started, solve this problem for me, it's worth it, right? So your core offer is more than just your signature system. It's more than just your steps. It's really the result you deliver. And when you look at it from that perspective, you know exactly what to say to somebody who's a potential client that helps zero in on the value in it for them. There's something really important I'm going to tell you about this piece in a minute. The third thing you need is an aligned blueprint for growth in your business. Now, this is more than just what's your funnel, what's your pyramid levels, because those things don't work the way you think they do. And on Sunday, I'm actually going to show you what a pyramid looks like that brings in people at different levels, how to know who is at each level, who it is that you want to attract. So which level do you actually want to work with? Who can you get results for? And how do you speak to them based on where they're at? Because there's levels of what we go through as humans in life, in business. Everybody's at different levels and you have to know who you're speaking to so you can speak their language. Again, I'll go into that more on Sunday, but you need an aligned blueprint for you that takes your core offer, that one thing you really love doing, that you're really good at, that you get amazing results at, and turns it into everything. So it's the freebies that will attract the right people for your offer, your lowest level products. So this might be anything, you know, under $500. What is this? Your eBooks, your workshops, your video trainings, your group program, your VIP days, your high ticket one-on-one offers. All of those come from your core offer. So when you know and are clear on that, I can show you in just a few minutes how to map out the entire rest of your business blueprint, your foundational courses and programs, in a way that everything feels aligned instead of feeling disconnected and schizophrenic, which I know is how a lot of entrepreneurs feel. Like you've got all these pieces and they're everywhere and they don't connect. So if you are feeling that way about it, imagine how your potential clients are feeling about it. Like if you don't understand your own offers and how they connect, how in the world are your clients going to understand that? How can they move between things in a way that makes sense if you don't know what that path is? So you've got to have that blueprint that's not just for you to know what's your next offer, how do they fit together, but also to know how do your clients enter and go through those different levels and different offers? How do they work together? So that's the next part. And then you need a best in the world statement. If I ask you, what are you number one best in the world at? What would you say? I've said that before and then said, hey, I probably should have said trigger warning before asking that. But you really do need to know, what are you number one in the world at? There is something that goes there for you. And it's a matter of a couple of things. Number one, getting really clear. Who do you work with? Why do you work with that audience? What's your unique system? Because if it's unique to you, you're the only one in the world who does that system, right? Are you getting the idea here? Getting closer? So who is it you work with very specifically? What's the unique system you use? And what's the amazing result you deliver? You put those three things together and you've got, what are you number one in the world at? And when you can show up and own that and confidently say, I am the best in the world at solving this problem for this audience with this system, everything changes energetically about your business and how you're showing up. Do you see how this helps next level you? Yeah. All right. The last thing is your CEO pledge. You are not your business. And if you really want a next level where you're at, you have to be able to separate yourself from your business and step into your role as CEO. Step into your role as the person who is guiding, who is intentionally, strategically growing your business, intentionally, strategically looking at your opportunities and saying, yes, no, here's where I want to go. And guiding everything based on your values and your goals. Because when you can do that, again, it's one of those game changers. I know that's a buzzword, but it's true. It really does change the way your business runs. So knowing how you choose, how you commit to yourself to show up for your business and to show up in the world changes things. That's your CEO pledge. So these are five pieces that most people who are in business have never taken the time to get clear on and express in a way that you've got a foundation for business growth. You've got a foundation not just to hit your next level, but your next 5 or 10 levels of growth in business when you know these pieces. So that's what I want to challenge you right now, to make time to really think these through and consider which pieces you're missing. What we're going to do on Sunday is dive into these, right? So here's the agenda for Sunday. We're going to really start with why. Why are you in business? Why'd you start your business? What's your goal? What's your big picture? What's your end game? What do you want to design? If you don't know what you want, you can't know what to notice for. You can't know what to zero in on and what to strategically do to get to that. So you got to really know, what's your why? What's your goal? Think about that. This is something that you can do some journaling around. You can go through these pieces on your own and start to get clear on them. The second thing is looking at your client acquisition differently. You are not a service provider. You are not a coach. You're not a consultant. You are someone who delivers a result. You are someone who solves a problem. You have to know what the problem is that you solve if you actually want to be able to attract clients to you in a different way. So instead of looking at, hey, here's my 5-step system, you really want to look at not just what's your system, what's your process, what's the result, but who is it perfect for? Because we've all had the experience of we bring clients into something who weren't a perfect fit and didn't get amazing results. That's a horrible feeling, right? You don't ever want a client who doesn't get an amazing result with you. So how do you fix that? How do we flip things around where instead of 98% of people failing with internet courses and with virtual trainings, you get 98% of your people succeeding? It's this. It's by knowing who are you best for? What's actually required on the client's side to get an amazing result with you? What do they need to have in place? What do they need to believe? What do they need to know about themselves, about their business, about you, about your business? How do we flip things so that the focus is results? We're going to dive into that. Number 3 is designing a mission-powered business model. Now, this goes back to that manifesto, because you need more than a logo and more than an elevator pitch if you want to stand out and be different. What's really different about you is what motivated you to get into business. What's your story? Tell me your story. Share that in your marketing. Tell me your mission. What was the problem you were having or you saw someone else having that you just had to solve? And you wanted to solve it so bad that you were willing to do this crazy thing called start your own business, right? What was it? Because when you tell that story, that's when you're going to get people in who not only become clients, but become raving fans to the point that they're referring people to you, that they're excited to bring people in and tell them about what you do so that you can help them too. When you flip things around and it becomes about a mission, then you've got something that's got legs. That's your movement. That's your revolution. What is that for you? This is where that idea of writing that manifesto comes in. The fourth thing is what I talked about a minute ago, your aligned business growth blueprint. None of this disjointed schizophrenic stuff anymore where you just throw out any offer that works or that you think might work or that you hope might get some interest. No, start with you at your core. Who are you? What are you here to do? What are you amazing at? And then how do you build around that? How do you put offers together that make sense in all of these different pieces so that you are aligned with it as you grow, that you are excited about it, and your ideal clients sense that excitement, they're attracted to it, and they want to work with you. The fifth piece is stepping into that CEO persona. This is the CEO pledge I mentioned. Who do you choose to be? How do you choose to show up? When you're having those challenging days, this is what you go back to. You don't have a business because you woke up and somebody just said, hey, here you go, here's a business. You have a business because you made a decision. Even if it started out as an accidental decision, you have continued, right? I'm an accidental entrepreneur. I didn't set out to start a business. I set out to go, okay, I need money in my checking account. What can I do, right? That was how I fell into it. But once I got started, it became intentional. It became, hey, you know what? I choose to own a business. I choose to build a business. I choose to do it strategically to create something amazing that both makes a profit and makes a positive difference. So what are the things that you've chosen? What have you decided or are going to decide are the way you want to show up, are the way you want to come across and communicate with people? What is your CEO persona and how do you step into that? Because if you want to take your business to the next level, you've got to do that. You've got to actually look at it like a business and you've got to say, hey, I choose to be the CEO of this business. Here are my goals. Here's how I'm going to reach them. And here's how I am going to show up every single day to create the result that I know is possible, to create the reality that I see as the next level for my business. All right. So there's some other cool things that are going to be happening on Sunday as well, but that's the basic overview of it. And I wanted to jump on and share that with you because I wanted you to have some ideas. I'm going to go back to this part right here of things that if you're looking to next level your business, you've got to have, you've got to get clear on, and then you've got to let that clarity help you get strategic. I can sit here and tell you all day that it's all about implementation, but it's not. If you're implementing the wrong things in the wrong order, it's not gonna work. Even if you're implementing the right things, if you do them in the wrong order, they won't work. You know, a funny story. I spent about 6 months at the gym, totally frustrated with my combination lock, like so irritated. Every time I would go to unlock my locker, I'd have to do it 3 or 4 or 5 times. And I couldn't figure out why. I could not figure out why my lock would not unlock. And it was one of those things that I'm like, okay, there's got to be more to what's going on here, right? What am I doing? And I finally realized I was putting in my lock combination 31, 29, 9. And about 25% of the time, it would open and I was good. The other 75% of the time, I would be like banging on the thing going, what's wrong with you, right? And then one day, I was flipping through photos on my phone and I had taken a picture of the combination when I originally bought the lock. And I realized my combination was not 31, 29, 9. No, those were all the right numbers, but I had them in the wrong order. My combination was actually 29, 31, 9. And that was one of those moments where I went, okay, well, the lock wasn't broken. There was nothing at all wrong with the lock. It was working exactly the way that it was designed to work. I had my correct numbers, but I had them in the wrong order. And sometimes that's how business is, right? Especially when you're doing it yourself and you're getting things in motion. You've got all the right pieces. You know, because you see it working for other people, right? You know, these are the 3 pieces I need. I'm going to learn this, this, and this, and that should work. But if you don't have them in the correct strategic order, you don't start with the right piece, the right number, you are never going to be able to unlock that lock. It's just going to frustrate you. Now, you might get lucky. 1 out of 5 times it might unlock because you didn't put the combination quite in right, which I realized is what I was doing. But if you get those right, the right numbers in the right order, it works every time. It works every time. And there's so much less frustration for me at the gym now that I have my combination correct again. But it's such a silly example to illustrate that idea of you have to have not just the right pieces, but you actually have to put them in the right order if you want things to unlock for you, if you want them to work. So if you're looking to really next level up your business and you've watched this for this long, then click the link below this video and join us on Sunday for the live stream. You're going to get access to what I'm teaching in the room, as well as some bonuses that really are designed to help you dive into those 5 things that I showed you on the page that will help you take your business to the next level. They will get you out of frustration and feeling disconnected, feeling like you're missing pieces or it isn't working mode into this is who I am. This is what I'm here to do. This is the problem I solve. These are the clients I do it for. And help you put those pieces together in a way that makes everything else work in your business so that you can finally create the results you're looking for without going crazy, without feeling like you just don't have time for all these pieces. Let's get just the right pieces. Let's get them in the right strategic order. And let's unlock that lock for you in your business. Join me Sunday. Click the link. Grab your spot now. You also get access to 18 bonus courses when you register. I know, crazy, right? But our focus Sunday is completely strategic. It really is. What's the big picture in your business? And I want you to walk away from that day with a plan and have access to all of my tactical trainings. So whatever your plan comes out as, you've got the tactical stuff, the step-by-step to back you up so you can make it reality. All right. I will see you there. Click the link now, reserve your spot, and let's get your business to the next level. There are people waiting for you to get out there in front of them with what you do. Let's make that happen.